What first inspired you to create your pieces?
Well, you see, art has been innate in me. I've been born with it. And for a long time, I was creating these pieces as creating art. But then I went through a phase of life where I became intensely spiritual. And then when I took up art after that, it took on a whole new meaning. My art took on a whole new meaning for myself. Mm-hmm. See, maybe before I wasn't giving it too much respect. It was only art. But then now it was infused with the spiritual life that it got. So that's where it all started.
Now, you consider yourself a divinely inspired artist. What does that mean personally to you?
Well, I am divinely inspired. The short answer to that is yes, I am. But then everything else is divinely inspired as well. Mm-hmm. Everything that is happening to ourselves, to this world, is all divinely inspired. Nothing can happen unless the permission comes from the top.
Okay. Is there one moment in your life as an artist that had a profound effect on your art?
Yes, it is. And that was not too long ago when I took up art again, and this was the time when my father was on his deathbed, and I was spending a lot of time nursing him. And one day I took up this piece of paper to draw upon, and I just looked at it first, and I looked at all the whiteness, and I'd been trying to figure out what this creation is all about, what is the time before creation, what is the time after creation, and what is the difference. And I'd heard phrases about duality and plurality.
Right.
Yeah. And I couldn't really understand it till I looked at this, and I said, well, this could be that oneness that they're talking about, the white paper. Mm-hmm. And then I picked up my pen and I drew a line. And then I said that this is the split of that oneness. So the one has become two now, the paper and the line. Mm-hmm. And then there are more lines there. So the paper is full of lines. So that has been broken, you see. That the diversity is there on the paper. And that is what creation is. And that the just the paper itself is the divine ground on which all this is happening. This universe is appearing on that divine ground of the white paper. Mm-hmm. And the one has become the many. And then when the image is finished, I looked at it again and I realized, well, that oneness is there again. It is still there. It is still contained within that piece of paper. So mm-hmm. that had a very profound impact on me. Mm-hmm. And that made me understand this subject that I was a bit confused about before. And that has happened a number of times mm-hmm. with me.
I know that there are times when you can easily do your art and other times where it just doesn't, it's not there. Well, why is that?
You see, when Vijay is not doing the art comes out well. When the ego of Vijay is absent, then it comes out well. Mm-hmm. Now, this can also be explained in another way. Vijay means the ego. So the ego is absent. And there are times, and I've read this somewhere, that you see, we have, our mind is of two types. There is the working mind and there is the thinking mind. The working mind is the more efficient mind. The thinking mind is the mind that is either in the past or is in the present. Or is in the future, mm-hmm. is worrying about the future or brooding about the past. So the times when the mind is there, neither in the past nor in the future, is in the now, is the most efficient mind. So I think when the mind is there, in the now, then the work comes up. Whatever work one is doing, not just painting, mm-hmm. whatever work you're doing, if you are in the now, the work will always come out well. So that is the difference there.
So when you're doing creating your art, are you consciously creating it, or do you create your art and then, but are you surprised by what you see?
It's both. You see, sometimes it is premeditated. Mm-hmm. I'd have thought of it before. I'd have read a phrase in a book before, and it, suddenly the idea comes to my mind. And sometimes I've drawn whatever, you know, it leads me to draw whatever appears on the paper, and then when I look at it, and then I start to think, and it reminds me of whatever, and I start to see meanings in it. Mm-hmm. So it is both ways.
What's more frequent for you? Which way does it come to you first, or what do you prefer? Is there one?
The one which is more spontaneous.
Oh, you do. Okay.
Yes, yeah.
And do you like those pieces
on
better?
The spot by itself, yeah. And sometimes I don't know where the line is going to end, mm-hmm. and how it is going to look.
Do you have a favorite piece? You're very prolific. Do you have one favorite piece that you love more than others?
I have, yes. There is, it's actually in the book where there is the planets, and there are the clouds, and there are the birds, and there is the silhouette of a man standing on ground, and there is this thin straight line running through all of them, mm-hmm. which depicts the oneness of everything.
Right.
So that would be my favorite.
I know that one too.
Yeah.
When did you realize or become to think of yourself as an artist? Or are you still in that process?
Well, you see, I took to art when I was very young. I had the talent, but I did nothing with it. I never sharpened the skill. Mm-hmm. I grew up with it. But it's only when I started to blend the two, the spiritual aspect with the drawing, mm-hmm. then it dawned upon me that now I am an artist.
How do you describe your art to someone who's never seen one of your pieces? How would you describe it?
Different. It's very different.
Yes. What do other people say about your art?
They say it is unique, and I agree with them.
Mm-hmm. Okay. What do you hope to achieve with your art?
Well, I hope to achieve that whoever looks at it becomes aware of something that is beyond matter, that is beyond this physical world. See, we are all of us so much involved in this physical phenomena that we rarely look at what is beyond that, what transcends this, what is responsible for the running of this. So I intend to create an awareness amongst whoever is viewing those pieces.
You said you've been artistic your whole life.
Yes.
How has your art changed? Is this a recent style that you've done it, or what?
It is a recent phenomena, going back to six years only, where it got the blend between the art and the philosophy started to take place. Mm-hmm.
Yes. What kind of art did you do before the spiritual?
The art was the same.
Okay.
It just took on a whole new meaning.
Okay.
Yes.
All right.